Now, the Swahili Kingdoms were established in eastern Africa in 700 AD by the indigenous Africans in the region. The Swahili Kingdoms were located alongside the Swahili coast in East Africa, from modern-day Somalia in the north down to modern-day Mozambique in the south. The entire Swahili coast region was about 3,200 kilometers in length, and the Swahili peoples were part of the larger Bantu people who branched out into the east and developed their own Swahili language. The kingdoms developed from the African fishing villages located along the coast between East Africa and the Red Sea, and also incorporated the surrounding African islands. Now to the west of the Red Sea, the region of Arabia was located, and the fishing villages expanded into cities over time, which was sometimes up to 70 acres in size. The key Swahili cities that these Africans established included Mogadishu, Gezira, Brava, Manda, Malindi, Mombasa, Zanzibar Island, Mafia Island, Kilwa Island, Tet, Sina, Sofala, and Comoro Island. The north of the territory was also known as the Land of Zanj. In addition to the key cities, the Swahili people also controlled a further 50 smaller cities in the region. By 1000 AD, the Swahili kingdoms had established themselves as the premier trading nation within the East African coastal region. The location of the Swahili kingdoms ensured that they became the predominant kingdom, whereby products from other empires in the interior of Africa, such as Great Zimbabwe, could be traded with Arab and Asian nations. Goods including gold, ivory, iron, animal skins, frankincense, grain, salt, and crystal were traded. The Africans of the Swahili kingdoms imposed taxes on any foreign merchant ships from the Indian Ocean which docked on their ports, which expanded their already large revenue streams. The Africans of the Swahili kingdoms were extremely advanced sailors. They developed two main types of ships to traverse the sea for trade. The ships with sails were named Dua Lamtepe, and the ships without sails were called Mtepe. Other ships, known as sewn boats, were also developed. These ships were constructed without the aid of nails, instead being sewn together. The Swahili kingdoms also employed the use of lateen sails, which were movable sails which allowed their ships to cross the ocean without the requirement for the wind to blow only from behind. This technology was not employed by European sailors until many centuries later. The Swahili sailors also utilized outriggers, which was a float that was attached to the main ship to provide additional stability. The outriggers could carry extra produce for trade if required. In addition, trade links were established between the Swahili kingdoms, China, and India. This specific trade network passed through the region of Oman in the Middle East near Arabia. Ivory from Africa was used for the creation of chairs and chess pieces in China and dagger handles in India. By 700 AD, Islam had spread to the Swahili kingdoms, primarily due to the close proximity to Arabia, the birthplace of Islam, and trade between African and Arab merchants. The first mosques were constructed in the region at this time, as the religion spread throughout the kingdom. By 900 AD, Islam had become the dominant religion of the Swahili kingdoms. And, at this time, the construction of mosques across the kingdom had begun. As the Swahili merchants were Muslims, this helped with the trade links to Arabs who were also the same religion. Within towns inside the kingdoms, an African Muslim ruler was usually established along with a council of elders. Kilwa Kisiwani was one of the city settlements of the Swahili kingdoms, located in modern-day eastern Tanzania coast, established in around 800 AD by the Swahili people. Kilwa Kisiwani became another hub for trade, where the Swahili merchants traded gold, silver, pearls, perfume, Persian goods, and Chinese porcelain. At its peak, the central city of Kilwa Kisiwani was thought to have approximately 12,000 residents. At Kilwa Kisiwani, stone buildings were built for the housing of the residents in the region, and also many ports and harbours to house their merchant ships. The Swahili people of Kilwa Kisiwani constructed the Great Mosque of Kilwa in 900 AD. The Great Mosque of Kilwa included a large octagonal bathing pool, numerous prayer halls, a dome in the ceiling, interlocking circular patterns for decoration, ablution area, and stairways. By 1000 AD, the Swahili people of Kilwa Kisiwani had begun minting their own coins, which were used in trade. In 1310 AD, the ruler of Kilwa Kisiwani, who was an African Muslim named Sultan Al-Hassan ibn Sulayman, constructed the palace named Husseini Kubwa. Husseini Kubwa was built from coral stone and comprises over 100 rooms. The palace also overlooks the Indian Ocean. The Swahili kingdoms continued to expand, trade, and prosper well into the year 1698 AD.